Wanted to know how to define and force clock to simulate your digital system? Normally, this section is used to define the clock frequency when you are designing a system which actually required clock input. That is the main application of it. But I'm telling you this trick for giving values to input ports other than clock. And by doing this, you do not need to force manual values to your input ports, and you can save time in your simulation. Here is a small note. For complex systems where multiple ports are present and includes system clock frequency too, this may create some complications. But for small systems, which we have in our roadmap of this course, you may find this easy. And we will be replicating it as well to save time. Let's start a quick demo. I'm taking code of digital AND gate, which we have created in our last video. So let's close it first. Closing it too. So this is our AND gate code we have written in our last video. I am going to simulation section, clicking on simulate behavior model. So we are on the simulation window, starting the simulation. Now right click on input A, select force clock, leave signal name as it is, leave radix as it is, leading edge value. Type 0 here, telling its adds value. Type 1 here, so it's a binary, so it can go from 0 to 1 only. So there are only two values. Leave starting at time offset as it is. Cancel after time offset. Leave it as of now. Duty cycle 50% set as default. Leave it as it is. Give period, say something like 100. Click on apply. Click OK. Now select signal B, right click, select force clock, same input we are giving, value 0 to 1, leave them as it is. Now period is half of last signal, so it's last time for the input A we have given 100, now I am giving 50. So click apply and OK and run our simulation. So you see the simulation, we have many values. So let's click at some point. So here the input value is 0. Input B is 0, so output is 0 because this is AND gate. Now at the next point, the input A is 0, B is 1, output is 0. Next value is input A is 1, input B is 0, output is 0. Next step, input A is 1, input B is 1, and D out is 1. So we didn't force input A and input B manually, but instead we defined clock for those and it gave us result for all four possible conditions. So let me brief what we did. We gave some clock frequency to input A. So in our case, we gave 100. Then we made half the frequency of clock to 50 and gave it to input B. So similar way, if we have the third input too, we're gonna halve the frequency again to 25 and would give it to next input. Hope you are liking the content. If you learned something today, please hit like, comment your suggestions, and please subscribe us and share with your connections too. Thanks. Have a great day. Bye-bye.